Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. If you guys have a Mazda, any Mazda such as Mazda 2, Mazda 3, Mazda 5, Mazda 6, Mazda CX-7, CX-5 guys, and your Mazda is shifting guys, hard, okay, the transmission is slipping, we'll show you guys what needs to be done to fix that correctly. Now, it could be something very simple and most people will not think about that. We'll show you guys what we use, all the tools and parts that we have and we use in the video will be listed in the description of the video below. This Mazda CX-7, we took it on a test drive and it started shifting really hard. The transmission was slipping, but not always, only sometimes. And once in a while it will shift real nice and smooth. So let us show you guys what causes that now. So first of all guys, let me show you what we're doing. Okay, I'm inside that Mazda CX-7 now. I'm going to go ahead, you know, start the car. And we're using, guys, here, okay, we're using Maxicom scanner, guys. Okay, this is amazing scanner. And you can use it on any car, not just Mazda. This thing is amazing. It works on any vehicle. You can access all the computers, read the data, see live data, and delete codes. And I'll go under transmission, and I try to read the codes and see if we have any problems here. Okay, and so far, guys, okay, check it out, it's establishing communication now. Big surprise. Okay, the car shifts really bad. Okay, it's jerking all the time. It says no fault codes detected, so there is nothing wrong with it. And we drove it about 200-300 miles, which is almost 400-500 kilometers, which is quite a bit. If you go to live data, okay, you can check all the different values here and all that stuff. And what we'll need to check now, guys, is the transmission fluid temperature. Ours right now, it's at 47 degrees Celsius. So what we're going to do, guys, we're going to check the transmission fluid level. On most Mazdas, guys, you need to consult your manual. You check your transmission fluid level at 65 or at 20 degrees Celsius. You need to have the emergency brake on. Okay, emergency brake on. Hold the brake. Okay, and you need to go now in reverse for about 5 seconds. Then you need to go to neutral for another 5 seconds. And after that, you will need to, guys, put it in drive for another 5 seconds. You want to do that? Okay, so you're going to go ahead and let the oil flow through the valve body inside the transmission. It's going to fill all the passages and you can get an accurate reading. And after that, we're going to leave it, guys, okay, in park, like that, with the emergency brake on. And we're going to check the fluid level now. Okay, let's check the fluid level now. Dipstick is right here. We're going to pull it out. Okay, let's wipe it and show you now what the dipstick looks like. Okay, you can see we have readings. From the bottom to right here, this is for 20 degrees Celsius reading. From here to here, it's for 65. Low and full mark. Right now, we are at 47 degrees on the transmission, so we should be around in the middle on the 65 mark. We'll go ahead, put the dipstick all the way in. Then we'll pull it out. And surprise, guys, we're not even reaching the 20 degrees Celsius mark, as you can see. We're definitely low on transmission. So that's what is causing the slippage in our case, most likely. We'll go ahead, guys, and if your transmission is even slipping, I'll recommend to use the Lucas additive. You can find this one listed in the description of the video below. This thing is amazing. Okay, it cleans and lubricates sticking valves. You can see proper shifting. It's really, really good stuff. So we usually add some of that to fill the transmission fluid, but you cannot add more than one bottle. And if you have to add more, always consult your manual. Now let me show you something else. Okay, if you come right here, you're going to notice in the manual what it says. Okay, low fluid level causes transaxle slippage. Transaxle is the transmission. Overfilling can cause foaming, loss of fluid, and malfunction. So low fluid level will cause slippage, guys. So we'll go ahead, add some, and we'll see if that takes care of our problem now. Stay with us. What we'll be doing now, guys, okay, we'll be using, okay, Lucas Transmission Fix. You can check this thing out in the description of the video below. It even recommends you to put it in a new transmission because it cleans, lubricates really good, okay, and results are immediate, guys. Now, saying results are immediate, in our case, it takes about, I drove it about 200 miles usually vehicle until everything is good with the transmission, and we didn't have any problems with slipping or anything like that on another vehicle. So we'll see if that will be the case, okay, with this transmission now. So we'll go ahead, add a bottle, make sure you don't overfill the transmission, and we'll see if that takes care of the problem now. So we went ahead and test drove the Mazda, guys, and we filled it to the full mark on the transmission. And after driving it, guys, for a little bit, it was still slipping. Probably there was air in the system. And after that, guys, after a while, probably about 5 to 10 miles, the car started shifting super nice and smooth, and we haven't had any problems since then. So hopefully, guys, the video will be helpful to you. Take care of your problem. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the channel for more videos, and see you guys next time.